This week on Why Mad, the V-Rock crew heads to Cedar Point to learn about one of the world's tallest and fastest roller coasters, Top Thrill Dragster.
Top Thrill Dragster was built in 2003 by a company in Switzerland called Intamin. The real excitement on Top Thrill Dragster is the launch. It's the feeling of being launched from 0 to 120 miles an hour in about 3.5 seconds. Top Thrill Dragster, the height is approximately 420 feet. It goes about 120 miles an hour. Now, one thing you have to remember is that the height and the speed that it goes over the top is an integral part. What happens when the train goes over the top of the lift? We can't have too many G-forces pushing you up out of your seat there. So the computer sees how fast that train went over on the previous launch. And then we'll adjust that speed that it launches it to compensate for the speed that's actually going over the top of the hill. The great thing about this track here is that it's all built on CAD and it usually all fits together within a 16th of an inch. The X and Y coordinates off a certain spot around here of each foundation are actually figured out to such a precise dimension that it's just it's mind-blowing. Dragster is so different from all of the traditional coasters we call chain lift hill coasters. As it goes up the lift, the potential energy of the train increases so that at the bottom of the next hill, it can get a lot of velocity, speed, kinetic energy. Dragster isn't powered up a lift hill. It's powered along a horizontal surface. It does that through stored hydraulic energy. What we have down in the hydraulic system at Dragster is what we call an accumulator system. For 45 seconds, there are four 700 horsepower pumps that actually pump up four accumulators. So over that period of time, it's storing 700 horses worth of hydraulic energy for that 45 seconds, and then it releases it in 3.5 seconds. If you do the math on that, it comes out to well over 15,000 horsepower that it exerts as it launches that train in a very short period of time. The braking system on Dragster is what we call an eddy current braking system. The rare earth magnets, which are incredibly powerful magnets, are mounted on the train, and we have copper alloy fins that are mounted on the track. These magnets on the train are very, very close and tight to these copper alloy fins. When they surpass these fins and go over and around them, it creates a force that opposes the motion of travel. And the great thing is that there's no direct contact friction involved. So there's no parts that wear, but without that non-contact, non-wearing braking system, this type of ride wouldn't be able to exist. I started my career working with roller coasters, working seasonally as a ride mechanic. When I was in college, I took design courses. I'm actually a mechanical engineer. I have civil engineers that design structures similar. We also have a great deal of electrical engineering that's involved in these. The complexity of the electrical system on these coasters has gone just skyrocketed over the last 10, 15 years. Having a base in math and science is just the epitome of what we do here and what we need to know to correctly maintain and build these rides.